Mr. President, let me start by echoing Botswana's appreciation for the convening of this high-level event, dubbed the SDG Moment. We find this initiative opportune as it has great potential to provide sustained impetus for SDG's implementation during this decade of action. Botswana, like many other countries, has been negatively affected by the COVID-19 pandemic, which came at a time when my government had just set out a transformative development agenda in line with the 2030 agenda to propel Botswana to greater heights. The unstable global economy has caused disruptions and fiscal constraints that exacerbated the existing national budget deficit. Our worsened fiscal position will curtail efforts geared towards SDG 8, decent work and economic growth. This could ignite negative ripple effects on the country's performance of other SDGs, given the interlinkages. It is indisputable that our ongoing efforts to develop high multiplier effects in job creation run the risk of being reversed by the impact of COVID-19. The small, medium, and micro enterprises are the hardest hit, as they lack the resilience to deal with the effects of the pandemic. Consequently, the purchasing power of households has been eroded, leaving many families looking up to government for assistance. Mr. President, Botswana, with her limited resources, has come up with a short-term COVID-19 economic relief package to support the economy and complement disease containment measures. The package covers interventions such as additional health expenditure, deferment of corporate tax on profit payable by firms, and a loan guarantee scheme to support access to bank credit by affected firms. Moreover, non-fiscal measures adopted include easing the monetary policy and introduction of additional liquidity measures for commercial banks to enable them to support economic activity. Botswana has also developed an economic recovery and transformation plan, which will complement the short-term economic relief package. Mr. President, my government is committed to closing implementation gaps to turn the COVID-19 crisis into a catalyst towards achieving the SDGs. As such, we have collaborated with the UN team in Botswana to develop comprehensive SDGs planning guidelines. The government will also develop an SDG financing strategy and its core institutional components through the design and implementation of an integrated national financing framework. This will strategically position Botswana to identify and leverage domestic and international public and private finance to support the realization of national priorities and SDGs. Botswana intends to collaborate with the international community to apply advanced fourth industrial revolution technologies towards the implementation of her development agenda. Another expected impact is efficiency in spending, cost containment, and avoidance of wastage to effectively deliver public services within the public sector. Mr. President, let me conclude by reaffirming Botswana's commitment and readiness to doing her part towards implementation of our internationally agreed development goals, aimed at leaving no man, woman, or child behind. We thus remain steadfast and determined to build back better and faster. Thank you for your attention.